Welcome, my name is Andy Morgan, and I'm a program manager in Azure AD. Today, I'm here to talk to you about identity security, why it's important, and what you can do to get more secure. There are primarily four different pillars to security: users, devices, apps, and data. Users bring identities, unique behaviors and usage patterns, and have varying levels of access needs depending on their role. Devices are used by a user to access applications and data. In recent years, more and more users have begun to use their own personal devices for accessing corporate data. Apps are the mechanism by which users typically access and manipulate data. And data is the core to what most organizations value as a regular everyday requirement of doing business. But also, protecting data helps you to maintain the trust of your customers, maintain a competitive advantage, and to protect your most valuable corporate assets. Traditionally, these four pillars have resided and been protected within the corporate network. With the advent of the cloud, however, we now have a sprawling ecosystem of users across multiple unique platforms. Users are bringing their personal devices ever more frequently into their workplace. Cloud-based applications are being implemented and adopted outside of traditional IT processes, and data is no longer centralized behind traditional network security. At Microsoft, our vision is for Azure AD to be the organizing foundation of a cloud-first world. By integrating your ecosystem with Azure AD, identity becomes the new control plane. Based on data collected from our own cloud services at Microsoft, we see an increasingly threatening landscape when it comes to cyber attacks. One of the most common attacks we see is breach replay. A breach replay attack occurs when a user reuses their corporate credentials with other sites and services. One of these sites is then breached. Attackers then attempt to replay these credentials against corporate resources and often sell or leak these usernames and passwords on the internet. If just one user in your organization falls prey to this attack, the attacker may then log into corporate systems. Using common tools, they can then download the user list or global address list from Exchange and initiate a password spray attack. A password spray attack uses common passwords, such as password 123, and hundreds of other well-known common passwords, against a large volume of user counts. The average success rate of a password spray attack is 1%. Now the attacker has compromised 1% of their users, they may initiate an intelligent targeted phishing campaign in order to compromise IT admins, executives, and also anyone associated with a more privileged user, such as an executive admin. A phishing attack typically comes in the form of an email, where the attacker attempts to trick the user into clicking on a link or entering their credentials into a malicious web page. Not only is phishing increasing in frequency, but its average success rate is about 15%. With a combination of these very common attacks that use passwords as their primary vector, you can see how quickly an attacker could use these methods to compromise a significant portion of your users. Now that we've discussed some of the most immediate threats to your organization's security, let's talk about how you can get more secure. Identity Secure Score is our in-product collection of identity security recommendations for protecting against attacks like the ones described in the previous slide, and to generally strengthen your security posture when it comes to identity. Identity Secure Score resides in the Azure portal and is tied to your environment. You can measure your secure score in nearly real time based on your configuration. You can use it to prioritize and plan improvements, and finally to track your progress based on our recommendations. Secure Score utilizes a list of recommendations and assigns a score to each of them for completion. In this example, 27 is the credited score for completed items, and 223 is the maximum obtainable score for all Identity Secure Score items. Your score is also compared to others in your industry, as well as to other companies of your size. You can also track your progress over time to show improvement. Here's an example of an Identity Secure Score recommendation. You can see the score impact, the current score, the maximum score attainable, the status, and a description of the item. Each item also contains additional details, such as a link to the location in the Azure AD portal where the item may be configured, and also more. Use the link provided here to go directly to your own Identity Secure Score in the Azure portal. In the next video, I will demonstrate the capabilities of the Identity Secure Score in the Azure portal and show you how to best leverage it to increase your security posture.